सर कृष्ण प्रदीप सर, यू कैन स्टार्ट। हाय
So, how are you, sir?
सर,
So, today we discuss about Telugu Jardava, English Jardava.
सर मेरे यू कैन यूज एनी लैंग्वेज और ऑडियंस पट्टी मेरे यू कैन गो विथ योर लैंग्वेज सर
ऑडियंस रिक्वायरमेंट बेटर होता है
ओके यू कैन
सो सिविल सर्विसेज अंटे फंडामेंटल गा दैट मीनिंग ఏంటంటే గవర్నమెంట్ ఎంప్లాయీస్ అంటే సో సర్వెంట్ ఆఫ్ ద సిటిజన్ The civil servant is a servant of the citizen. Then, but practically, most of the civil servants think that they are the master of the people, but not as a servant of the people. So, generally, civil servant ni mano even public servant are put out. So, public servant aneri kuncha broader meaning lo kai. ఈ సివిల్ సర్వీస్ లో ఎంటర్ అయితే మనకి ఉండేటటువంటి జాబ్స్ ఏ విధంగా ఉంటాయి. ఎనీ పోస్ట్ రేంజింగ్ బిట్వీన్ విదేశ్ సెక్రటరీ టు క్యాబినెట్ సెక్రటరీ ఈజ్ అ సివిల్ సర్వీస్. సో సివిల్ సర్వీస్ ఒక విదేశ్ సెక్రటరీ అంటే లోయెస్ట్ లెవెల్ లో ఉండేటటువంటి గవర్నమెంట్ ఎంప్లాయీ. క్యాబినెట్ సెక్రటరీ హైయెస్ట్ సివిల్ సర్వెంట్ ఇన్ ద కంట్రీ. But he's a senior most civil servant and drawing the highest salary in the country among all the civil servants. He's the leader of all the civil servants in the country. So, in civil services, we have to pravesh in chali ante, maraki, yeh rakanga examination of the the people who are who wanted to enter into the civil service will be selected by the UPSC. UPSC is the Union Public Service Commission. So Union Public Service Commission every year February second week lo like oka notification and for the selection of the civil services oka common civil service exam ki sambandhinchinatvanti notification. So ee notification ichin tarvata online lo students candidates apply chesukochu. Meeku oka 3 to 4 weeks time kuda ivvadam jarugutundi online lo maatrame application pettu అండ్ అప్లికేషన్ పెట్టుకున్న తర్వాత ఎగ్జామినేషన్ ఒక త్రీ లెవెల్స్ లో కండక్ట్ చేస్తారు. సో ద ఎగ్జామినేషన్ విల్ నాట్ బి కండక్టెడ్ ఇన్ ఎ సింగిల్ స్ట్రోక్. ఇట్ వుడ్ బి కండక్టెడ్ ఎట్ త్రీ లెవెల్స్. సో ఈ త్రీ లెవెల్స్ ఏమంటామంటే ప్రిలిమినరీ ఎగ్జామ్, మెయిన్ ఎగ్జామ్ అండ్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ అంట. సో ఈ ప్రిలిమినరీ మెయిన్ అండ్ ఇంటర్వ్యూ. ఈ ప్రిలిమినరీ ఏమో ఒక ఆబ్జెక్టివ్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్, మెయిన్ అనేదేమో డిస్క్రిప్టివ్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్, ఇంటర్వ్యూ ఏమో ఇట్స్ అ పర్సనాలిటీ టెస్ట్, ఓరల్ టెస్ట్. సో సో ఈ మూడు మూడు త్రీ లెవెల్ ఎగ్జామినేషన్ లో సిస్టమ్ లో మనకి ఫస్ట్ వచ్చేది ప్రిలిమ్స్. ఈ ప్రిలిమ్స్ అనేదేమో the preliminary examination will be conducted in the last week of the May, last Sunday of May. Usually this is the trend, but this year because of the conditions existing because of the COVID, you know, the examination may probably postpone. And actually it is scheduled to be held on May 31st this year, but there are the possibilities of explanation postponement will also be there. So keeping this in view, but usually the UPSC will conduct this examination only on the last Sunday of May every year. And after the preliminary examination, 3 months gap will be given. And after 3 months, usually in the month of September, third week, the main examination will be conducted. Main examination will be in the descriptive manner. And after the mains examination of descriptive approach, there will be interview in the follow up in the following year, not immediately. Usually it would be in the month of February or March every year. So that is the general schedule of the examination. Apart from this schedule of the examination, what are the different papers that are part of the examination? So in the preliminary examination, you will be having a general studies paper and a civil service aptitude test paper. then who will be eligible to take this examination? The eligibility, fundamental eligibility criteria to take the examination is the graduation of any category. Any graduate of any stream or background will be eligible to take this examination. Whether you belong to BA, BTech, BCom, or BSc, or MBBS, from any background, you can take the examination. And you don't have to have 60% marks, or you don't have to have any 70, 80, 90% marks. Just 45% marks are adequate. Any graduation recognized by the government, by the UGC, is adequate. Second point, what are the minimum age and maximum age limit? Somebody is also asking about this. The minimum age limit for taking the civil service exam, by the time you apply for the examination, is 21 years. And the maximum age limit varies from OCs to upper caste to the OBC and SCST. For the OCs, it is 32 years. And for the OBCs, 3 years relaxation is given. And for the SCST, 5 years relaxation is given. That means SCST candidates can take the examination up to the age of 37. OBCs can take the examination up to the age of 35. So according to the age limit, the number of attempts are also limited here. For example, for the OC candidates, the number of attempts are only 6. For OBC candidates, the number of attempts are 9. And for the SCST candidates, there is no limit on the number of attempts. So that is the general fundamental qualification, including the age qualification and the educational qualification. No experience is required. Experience is not the criteria for taking the civil service exam. And another requirement is you need to be a citizen of India. Either you can be a natural citizen of India or a naturalized citizen of India, but you're supposed to be a citizen of India to be eligible to take this examination. And then after this qualification, so then you have to apply for the exam, and after application, applying the examination online, the examination will be conducted offline only. There is no online examination for this. The fee structure will be the examination, the fee structure is very simple. Now the fee structure is only for 200 rupees. And even for the OBC and SCST candidates, there is no fee structure at all for applying the examination, for the examination. And the preliminary examination, you'll be having two papers, as I told you, two general studies and a civil service aptitude test. So what is the general studies? General studies consists of the social studies subject that you have studied in your 10th class, plus general science and current affairs. So in the social studies subjects in your 10th class, you have focused on history, geography, economy, and polity. So these are the major core subjects. The important core subject is the civil service exam, history, geography, economy, and polity. And the other subjects are environment and ecology, science and technology, and current affairs. So these are the major components and considered to be the core subject in the entire examination system. And then there is a second paper called CSAT, that is Civil Service Aptitude Test. And the Civil Service Aptitude Test contains several aptitude related subjects, including decision making, communication, interpersonal skills, problem solving skills, and mental ability, reasoning, data interpretation, comprehension. So these are the various subjects that will form part of the civil service aptitude test. So what is this civil service aptitude? Civil service aptitude means whether you have ability to become a civil servant or not will be tested in this examination. So somebody is asking a question, in preliminary exam, what type of questions, like fact-based or application-based? So in the preliminary examination, there will be multiple choice questions, both in the paper 1 and paper 2. So these multiple choice questions are divided into three types. 33% questions will be factual questions. Another 33% questions will be application-oriented questions. another 33% questions will be analysis oriented questions. So by a combination of all these three, you would be given questions. For example, there was a question last year from the field of science and technology. Generally, we use Bluetooth, we use Wi-Fi. And there was a question about which of the following are the differences between Wi-Fi and the Bluetooth. Earlier, there was a question, identify the difference between DVD, Blu-ray, and CD. So such kind of application questions. And there are also questions like, what is the coating that is used on a frying pan? The Teflon coating that is being used on the frying pan, focusing on that, the question was given. So like this, even in the political process also, the questions will be associated with the fundamental rights, fundamental duties, how the government functions at the union level, state level, and at the local level. The functioning of the government at various levels. So the preliminary level examination, there will be equal classification of the questions into 33% of basic factual questions, 33% of questions based on the understanding and application, and another 33% questions will be based on the analysis. So that is how in the general, it is both in the general studies as well as in the, you know, civil service aptitude test also, questions will be classified accordingly. On an average, every year around 10 lakhs people from around the country will take this civil service exam. Then how to stand out of this crowd when you are taking the civil service exam? Because though 10 lakhs people apply for this, the number of candidates who will take the examination will not be actually more than 4 lakhs to 5 lakhs. Only between 4 to 5 lakhs people will actually take the examination. Remaining all other people, they will actually get absconded from the examination. So out of this 4 to 5 lakhs people, serious aspirants will be not more than 50,000. And who are these serious aspirants? Serious aspirants are those people who have joined a coaching institute and are taking the test series, and they are regularly preparing in notes, and they are thoroughly applying whatever they wanted to do according to the requirements of the examination. So therefore, the serious aspirants who are preparing across the country, not just only in AP or Telangana, across the country, the candidates will be applying for the examination, and the not more than 50,000 people will be there who are the serious aspirants. And out of this 50,000 people, the candidates will be called for the next level of examination. That is the main examination, the descriptive examination. And somebody is asking more 1%. What? More 1%? I don't understand. So in the main examination, there are 9 papers. The candidates will be selected in a 1:12 ratio. 1:12 ratio means if there are 1,000 posts in a particular year, 12,000 candidates will be selected for the examination, for the main examination, in a 1:12 ratio. And in the main examination, there are 9 papers, as I told you. And in these 9 papers, these 9 papers are classified into 3 types: qualifying papers, compulsory papers, and optional papers. 3 types of papers are there across these 3 levels, across these 9 papers. Qualifying papers. The first 2 papers are the qualifying papers. And what are those qualifying papers? They are the language papers. One is Indian language paper, and the second is general English paper. These 2 papers are of 10th class standard, and each paper consists of 300 marks. So this Indian language paper first. Indian language paper means any Indian language, including Telugu, Hindi, Kannada, Malayalam, Tamil, any language that you can select, which is being recognized by the Constitution of India in the 8th schedule. There are 22 languages recognized by the Constitution of India. You can choose any one of these languages according to your knowledge, basic awareness. usually the candidates will choose that subject which they have studied as a second language in their 10th class, because they have more or less acquaintance with this second language in their 10th class. So those who are having minimum skills of reading and writing in a particular language can be chosen as an Indian language paper. And there is general English paper. General English paper is also a very simple paper. You don't have to, if the people are from the regional medium background, they don't have to be worried about this English language paper, because it is of 10th standard only. It is the standard of questions are based on, you know, reading comprehension and writing abilities, to test your reading and writing abilities only, that in English language paper will be conducted. Both these two papers are, only qualifying papers, Indian language and general English paper. 33%, three parts, like total 99. What is the matter of more percent, Mr. Anil Kumar? More or less 33%, 33 1/3. It is not absolutely 33. One section would be 33, another section would be 34, another section will be 33 again. So more or less 33% on average. The questions will be easy and average, and difficult questions will be given. So in the second category of the mains papers, you will be having what you call as the compulsory papers. In the compulsory papers, there are five papers. Among these five papers, one is general essay paper. General essay means a piece of topic will be given, and the candidate is expected to write a general essay upon that. The general essay paper is for 250 marks. The entire there will be two sections in the general essay paper, each section consisting of four questions, and the candidate is required to select one question from each section. Means the candidate has to write two general essays, from section A and another from section B. And the title itself is suggesting the piece of topic would be only general in character, not any specialized area. So this general essay paper would be expecting the candidate to take a generalistic perspective on a given particular issue. Suppose in the ongoing situation, in the coming mains examination, the UPSC may be giving a question related to the COVID-19, the coronavirus. Suppose if you are given a question about the COVID-19, you are not just supposed to write about only the virus and its characteristics. And you have to give a political, geographical, historical, scientific, technological, governance oriented, environmental aspects from all the dimensions that you have to analyze the issue. Suppose governance related issues related to the COVID, then economic impact of the COVID and environmental impact of the COVID, geographical expansion of the COVID. So from a historical background of the COVID, from all these dimensions, one has to answer this general essay, from just any one single dimension. And then you have four general studies papers among the common papers. After the general essay, there are four general studies papers. Whatever the general studies subjects that you have studied in the preliminary level will also be there in the main form, including the polity, economy, geography, history, science and technology, environment and ecology, biodiversity. In addition to those traditional areas, in the main examination, you'll also have additional areas. There are traditional and additional areas. So suppose in the general studies paper one, you have geography, some Indian national movement, world history, modern Indian history, Indian culture, Indian society. These are the areas in the paper one. And in the paper two, you have the topics like Indian polity, Indian constitution, governance in India, and international relations. And in the paper three, you have the topics associated with Indian economic development, science and technology, environment and ecology, biodiversity, disaster management, security management. Then in the paper 4, you have ethics, integrity, and aptitude. So this each of these papers will comprise of 250 marks. Paper 1 or paper 2, paper 3, and paper 4 are the general essay. Every paper will consist of the 250 marks. So the subjects, somebody is asking for the repetition of the subjects. So in the paper 1, you have national movement, freedom struggle, Indian struggle, modern India, and world history, post-independent India, modern history, post-independent India. Post-independent India is a follow-up of the Indian freedom struggle and Indian national movement from 1947 to till date, that is the post-independent India. Then in geography, in both Indian geography as well as world geography. Then Indian society, Indian culture. They're all part of this paper 1. Then in the paper 2, polity, Indian constitution, and you also have India, governance in India, and international relations. Four areas are there in the paper 2. Indian polity, Indian constitution, governance in India, and international relations. And in the paper 3, we have Indian economy, comprising of almost 100 marks. Science and technology, biodiversity, science and technology, biodiversity, environment and ecology, and disaster management, and security management. These areas are the paper 3 areas. And in the paper 4, you have ethics, integrity, and aptitude, with 7 chapters around. Each of these papers consists of 250 marks, not more than 250 marks. Whereas language papers, Indian language and general English paper, each of those two papers will be for 300 marks. In those papers, you are supposed to qualify. And the marks that you have gained in the language papers will not be added to these papers, the main paper, the compulsory papers. They will not be considered for the final ranking. Just you have to qualify with the 40% marks. So that is the main compulsory papers. And you have optional paper. There are two optional papers. Among the two optional papers, you choose one optional, and each optional will have two papers. Any optional you can select. The UPSC has given a list of around 56 optionals. Among these optionals, the most popular optionals are public administration, political science and international relations, generally which is called as a PSIR, anthropology, sociology, geography, history, and literature. Any literature, you can, depending upon your mother tongue, you can choose any literature. Suppose if your mother tongue happened to be Telugu, you can select Telugu literature. If you happen to be a Malayali, you can select Malayalam literature. So any literature can be selected. It is not compulsion that you have to select the literature. It is one of the options that is being given. So why these options are become popular? The public administration, political science, sociology, anthropology, these optional papers in geography or history have a lot of compatibility with the general studies papers, which are the common papers. Optional papers will be taken by the, will be chosen by the candidates according to their choice. While compulsory papers, the general essay, the general studies papers 4, they will be chosen according to their compulsory for the candidate, while optional is taken by the candidate. So somebody is asking, what is the best optional for IAS? That is what I am telling. There is a list of 7 optionals, like public administration, political science, sociology, anthropology, geography, history, and any literature paper. Out of these 7, you can choose any paper. But while choosing the optional, you have to take care of how far it is useful for the common papers, that is the general studies papers. Depending upon this compatibility only, the selection of the optional should be there. And optional will consist of 500 marks with 250 marks each for two papers. And so therefore, in all, around 1700 marks in the mains papers, across the mains papers, that is 250 marks for each of the five common papers, that is 1250, and 500 marks in the optional paper, together 1750 marks would be there for the main examination. As I told you that already, the language marks, the two language paper marks will not be added to the final ranking. And those who qualify in this main examination will be called for the interview. So this interview is known as the personality test. And the candidates will be selected for the interview in a 1:2 ratio. That means if there are 1,000 posts, 2,000 candidates will be selected for the interview. And out of these 2,000, personality test will be conducted. It is called as the personality test because the UPSC will test the personality of the candidate to see how far the candidate is suitable for the civil services. How far he can work as a servant of the people. So, which are the best books to prepare for the civil services? And we have 5 minutes and we reconnect after 5 minutes. Let me finish about the interview system. We can finish it in 3 minutes. So then the personality test, there will be two types of questions. One is the questions based on the biodata. That means your name, your parents, the background of your parents, what the job that you have been doing, and your educational background, your district information, the information about your state, and they're all the biodata related questions. If you happen to be doing any job, the questions will also be about your job. The questions will also be about your hobbies. And then the other type of questions in the interview will be based on the current affairs. The current affairs may be ranging between local current affairs of your state, regional current affairs, national current affairs, and international current affairs. So they're the two types of questions. In this interview, UPSC will only see how far you can justify a particular argument. The UPSC will not ask any bit-based question. UPSC will never ask you, what is the capital of India? The UPSC will only ask you, why Delhi is being chosen as the capital of India? Why not something else? So UPSC would like to make you to stock something. Whether you have communication skills to justify your answer or not will be tested by the UPSC. Therefore, the UPSC has named it as what is called as the personality test. So here we conclude and we continue after 5 minutes.
Yes, sir. Thank you so much. So since we are saving all the session here, the entire Zoom session is getting recorded. It takes around 5 to 8 minutes to get saved on the computer. And again, we'll reconnect after the 8 minutes. And all those participants who are here, kindly rejoin. Don't miss out because this is the most important session for all of you. So thank you, sir. Krishna Pradeep, sir. We'll reconnect in 5 to 8 minutes, sir. Thank you. Thank you so much.